don't always tell the truth. Do you ever feel like there's just too many rules to follow? I'm not saying there shouldn't be rules and laws, but I rail against those that seem unjust and benefit one group over another. That's one thing I love about the Episcopal Church. We're not too burdened by do nots. For those of you who have lived in Grand Rapids for a long time, you may remember that nothing happened on a Sunday. I moved here on a Sunday in 1984, and after unloading the truck and working afternoon, we went to find food. Well, there was no grocery store, there was no store open, no restaurant. I learned quickly that people didn't cut their grass on Sunday, or work in their yards, or hang out their laundry. My 9-year-old son got a paper route, and when he went to collect on Sunday, people wouldn't pay him because it was Sunday. I knew it all had to do with the Sabbath and work on the Sabbath. And I was there about to start a new job in healthcare where I would work every day, every Sunday. What will the neighbors think? In today's gospel reading, the leaders of the synagogue maintained power and control by adding rules to the Mosaic law. In this case, laws about the Sabbath. The new man-made rules were so strict that they became oppressive. Their definition of work included just about anything, even how far you could walk. The commandment reads, "Remember the Sabbath and keep it holy." The true spirit of do not work meant rest, like God did. Give glory to God for his creation. In fact, the ancient Sabbath restrictions did not include a ban on all working. It was permitted to save lives. Jesus' healing of a crippled woman appears to be an act of compassion for a suffering person, but it was perceived as a threat to the law and challenge to the power of the authorities, who were already out for him. Jesus condemned their hypocrisy. They water their oxen on the Sabbath, but won't care for the child of God. Their law cared just enough to save a life, but not enough to help those in need. They show no concern for a suffering woman. For Jesus, there was no wrong time to do the right thing, even on the Sabbath. In fact, there may be no more fitting time because the true spirit of the Sabbath was honored. This wasn't the first time that Jesus healed on the Sabbath or violated Jewish custom or a rule held rigidly by the leaders. In the Gospel of Mark, he healed the man with the withered hand in the synagogue on the Sabbath. He talked to women. He touched a leper, and he was touched by a woman doesn't hear hemorrhage. But this story is about more than working on the Sabbath. Jesus broke the law to set the woman free from disease because it was the right thing to do. But it's also about being set free from unjust laws and laws that oppress and that are applied unjustly. Jesus violated laws when it was the right thing to do. Breaking them placed the love of God above man-made rules. Jesus doesn't play by our rules, and he expects us to play by God's rules. In his book, The Bad Habits of Jesus, theologian Leonard Stewart writes, "In God's kingdom, the house rules apply, and the only rule God has is the rule of love. And the rule of love leads to different worship than the red carpet or the White House or Wall Street. God does not love in theory, but in action. Jesus doesn't want to control us from the outside, but to guide and channel us from the inside. Those who view their mission in life to be yardsticks and scales for others run the risk of developing wooden and metallic souls." Jesus taught us that there are only two laws we have to obey: love God and love your neighbor. Having this freedom brings about the transformation that we need by giving us the power to do God's work in the world, to change the world around us so it looks more like the kingdom of God for all of us. It can be done. Think of the people in history that have stood up to power to do the right thing. Like Jesus, Gandhi, and Martin Luther King Jr. led movements of nonviolent resistance to challenge systems of oppression. There are so many examples of injustices, and yet there are people with the courage to stand up and speak up. Today we have unjust bail bond laws that discriminate against people of color and poor people. A young man in New York was accused of stealing a backpack at age 16, and he was held in jail for 3 years because his parents could not pay the bail. So Trinity Wall Street, an affluent Episcopal church in Manhattan, joined a mass bailout of detainees being held in the jails. We have laws that allow us to maintain a humanitarian crisis at our southern border, where our neighbors are living in deplorable conditions and families are being separated. Courageously, the Evangelical Lutheran Church of America has declared itself to be a sanctuary church, walking alongside and supporting immigrants. We have laws that allow people to buy and use weapons of war against their and our neighbors. In Dayton, El Paso, Orlando, cities too many to mention, in our places of work and worship, and school and play. The House of Bishops and the Episcopal Church has taken strong stance against gun violence and supports legislation on gun safety and return reform. We even repeal laws that protect creation, allowing companies to engage in harmful practices and hurt people. The Episcopal Church has long stood by the indigenous Greenwich people, defending their right to existence and sustainability in their sacred land in the Arctic National Wildlife Refuge. The list goes on and on of unjust laws and rules. As is often true of those in power, their rules are not burdensome for them. They make rules that maintain the status quo, keep themselves in power, and keep the other in their place. It's up to us to create the world as it should be, to recognize injustices in our communities and the world and take action. Jesus did not come to abolish the old laws and traditions, but to show us that when there's a choice between the law and love, love always wins. There's never a wrong time to do the right thing. It may be difficult. It often takes courage. It may even get you killed, as it has in many cases. But if it's done for the sake of justice and mercy, it is what God wants. Jesus calls us to reach out with compassion and mercy to those who are hurting, to help right the injustices that we see. Jesus reminds us that there is never a bad time to be an instrument God's grace in the world.